Hi, in this video I'm going to cover details I have left behind in the first two ones, and I hope the first two ones were helpful enough for you. Okay, starting from these icons over here, the first one enables you to see your part either with or without shadows. The second option enables you to see it in perspective mode or in non-perspective mode. The second icon changes the background of yours, which is very helpful when you want to render your file and apply lights. The third one changes the appear of your part, like you can change the color, transparency, shininess, and some other features in the advanced area, but in this area you can only change the color, and it's more in handy when you want to render your file again, but you can use it when you don't want to render it as well. You have five options over here. The first one, select part, changes the whole part's color altogether. If you delete it and choose this, you can change the color of surfaces manually. And the third one is for surfaces with no thickness, which we do not have at the moment. The fourth one is for bodies, which we only have one. If you had more than one, you could change their color independently, but here it just works as one part. And this one is for features. You can open this. Oh, let me change the background and come back in here again. Okay, no, even worse. Okay. This one over here, you can change the feature. And how can you do that? Either clicking on the feature over here, or you could just open this combo over here and choose it. Like this. As for this one, it hides and shows a couple of features, which, to be honest, are not that necessary. This one enables you to see your part either with edges shown or with no edges, or in wireframe, or if you want to see the hidden lines, all of that. This one changes the view, isometric, symmetric. Or, okay, this one is very handy actually. It's a cross-section view. You just need to define a plane and click on it. And you can, because I have clicked on it before, you can move the plane around. You can angle the plane here. You can add another plane like this, two different colors. This is the result of two cross-sections. The part is not actually cut. It's just a view. Whenever you disable this button, it goes away. It's a previous view. It zooms to a specific area. This one, zoom fit, not very handy. Okay, back to the sketch tab. Convert entities. It's very handy, very useful. If you just click on the surface, for example, and click sketch, normal two, and you wanna have an sketch exactly as the projection of this rectangle on this plane. So you click on it, click on the rectangle, and click OK. If you wanna add the circle too, just click on it, click OK. As you can see, the sketch is on this plane, just a projection. And you can do whatever you want with it, like this. Yeah. Back to the features tab, linear pattern. You need to define a feature to pattern, this feature. Then you need to define directions. You have two directions, by clicking on any edges, which is in favor of your attention to do the pattern, like this. The distance between each number of it, maybe direction 2 this way, change the flip set number 3. There you go, just like that. You have the option of circular pattern, which you need to define an axis, usually a circle. Let me just show you by doing that. If I edit this pattern and decrease this to 2 and this one to 0, now I'm going to circular pattern that one, this around this like that, equal spacing this. Now that you have your part, for example, you can apply materials to it by right-clicking over here, material not specified, right-click, edit material. And you have a library of materials with their information over here, their elastic modulus, their density, yield strength, and other specifications. Apply. When you apply material on your part, you can go to the Evaluate tab, and by clicking on Mass Properties, you can see its center of mass. You can see, actually, center of mass, it's not in accordance to material. You have it anyway. You can see your mass of the whole part, 841 grams. Okay. I told you I'm gonna show you how you can have center line here, for example. If you just right click on this area, and by the way, some people by mistake drag this around and they just don't know what to do with it, just double click on it. It goes back where it was. Right click on this blank area, come down and customize to the command tab, sketch, center line. Just drag and drop it here. Okay, I hope these videos, these past 3 videos I uploaded on YouTube, help you to get more clue of how SolidWorks operates and how user-friendly it is. Please pardon my many English mistakes. Obviously, this is not my first language, so I did my best. And please let me know if you want me to cover any other areas in SolidWorks which I may have left, or you are curious to know about. Okay, thank you very much for watching. Till later, bye.